The 9mm handgun is an excellent, excellent choice for concealed carry. Welcome back to AmmoMart.com, where you can find real firepower online. Today we would like to continue drilling down on the 9mm caliber. In the past we talked about its history, and then we verified beyond a reasonable doubt that it does in fact have plenty of stopping power. Today we would like to talk about where it fits in the concealed carry platform. I have arranged a bunch of options for a potential user in the concealed carry version of a lot of different guns. I have some Glocks, some Springfield Armory, some SIGs, some Smith & Wesson. And what I'd like to do first is talk about what one would probably need in selection of a 9mm concealed carry weapon. First, I think people should spend as much time talking about what actually goes on in civilian-involved shootings as they do the gun they want to purchase, because once you have a firm grasp on what actually is entailed in most civilian shootings, it can help you point the way towards the gun you need to select. For instance, studies show, beyond a reasonable doubt, that most civilian-involved shootings take place in a dimly or low-lit area. That's extremely important when you make your selection, because if you buy a gun that you can't see the sights, it's probably not going to do you much good in a dark alley. Related to sights, there are dozens of options on the market. What's important for you to understand, however, is that they're not all the same. For instance, this is the Springfield Armory Hellcat. And if you don't know a whole lot about guns and you look down the front of the muzzle there, you'll notice it has a nice red pipe. Some people incorrectly assume that that fiber optic sight is going to help them in a low light area. In fact, it won't. It works better when there's plenty of sunlight. So if you take the gun out of the case in the store and go, wow, I can really see that. If you hold your hand over the muzzle and sort of cup, you'll notice it almost disappears. It is in fact not visible at night and in no way glows. Moving on, you have some, the Glock has the rectangle and the circle. Also, even though it's white, might be hard to see in a low lit area. And then you can move on to some that are manufactured to actually glow in the dark, or tritium, whatever sort of trade name they're using. They work much better in low light areas. The SIG 938 also has that feature. Really something to consider is just because you can see it in the store doesn't mean you can see it in the dark. Another thing people need to consider when choosing their concealed carry platform is reliability. I would personally decide that if I was going to carry a gun on my person, that I need it to function reliably every time. Some people, I know money's everything and lots of folks are on a budget that leads them to select the gun they do. All I can say is I hope that works out for you. Do your homework though, and if at all possible, do not compromise on your weapon's reliability. I'm not here to endorse any one product over the other. I've selected these for a specific reason, which is that I've shot these weapons numerous times and would in fact trust my life to them, and I wouldn't put something out that I didn't. So do your homework on reliability. There's a lot of information out there via the internet or magazine articles, fantastic sources of information. Magazine capacity. How much ammunition do I need? A lot of people in this industry I respect use the term adequate, an adequate supply of ammunition. That can be a pretty relative thing. I can tell you, going back to the statistics of civilian-involved shootings, the idea that you're going to get into a Miami Vice-style gunfight out there is very unrealistic. It just doesn't happen. In fact, there's less than 4 rounds of ammunition expelled between the two parties in a civilian-involved shootings, according to the latest statistics. So your magazine design is important not only in how many tries you get, so to speak, but it also lends itself to the shape and the size of the weapon that you may find comfortable or extremely uncomfortable, as the case may be. This is a standard sort of single stack 6-round 9mm. You'll notice when we hold up the SIG 938 here, not much handle, okay? Not much to get a hold of. That means that the gun can be a little difficult to control for some people, or people that are not experienced shooters. Which leads me to my next point. Regardless of the magazine style, you'll notice some are bigger. Regardless of that, small guns are in fact not easier to shoot. That's one of the big myths you have to overcome in the gun business if you're in sales or working with people on the range. Simply not the case. Sometimes small guns, the only thing they do well is hide. They're terrible range guns related to a limited sight radius. It's not a lot to get a hold of to control the gun. And at the end of the day, they're never going to be perfect range guns. They weren't designed for that. They were truly designed for concealment. So you have to keep that in mind if you're not an experienced or proficient shooter, that you may struggle with these a bit before you have a chance to be trained. There are products out there that give you a fabulous amount of capacity. This is the 13 rounder from the Hellcat. The SIG 365 right here has 10. But what's interesting about that is a lot of them, even that are single stack sixes, have floor plates that you can modify the geometry, lengthen this for more purchase on the handle. And it also can increase the magazine capacity by as much as 2 rounds. Some of those floor plates just change the shape, some change shape and magazine capacity. So pay attention to that if you do want to modify the plate. It's actually pretty simple to do. You just kind of figure out how your magazine works, push a button, remove the floor plate, put the new one in, and off you go. Another thing one needs to consider about what type of concealed carry gun they would like to purchase is how well do you shoot it, and are you ever going to be able to learn to shoot it well? Give you a good for instance back to the SIG. A lot of people struggle with this gun even though it's fantastically well made, and I find to be very accurate. Their hands are just all over it, doesn't work. So certain manufacturers, this is the Smith Easy Slide. This is kind of getting on the far edge by size of what some would consider a concealed carry gun. In my humble, I don't know that Smith ever designed it to be a concealed carry gun. It's just sort of more or less been perverted into that. One of the great things about this is people shoot this gun very well with very little experience, at least my observation from working with folks on the range. Now the Glocks basically have two types. This is the magazine to a Glock 26, and when you pick this up, you'll notice it feels completely different than its Glock Model 43 cousin. That's because it's a stack and a half magazine, short but fat handle. It's one of those guns you're either going to like when you pick it up or you're going to hate. I can tell you this much, when you're at the counter, if you pick the gun up and it doesn't feel right, it feels like, I don't like that, you will never learn to like it. If it doesn't fit right out of the gate, just like shoes don't stretch, this thing, you're never going to like. Trust me, you'll know right away whether it's a go or a no-go. Perhaps the most important thing to talk about when you make your selection for concealed carry is, what safety features do I need on the gun? There's a lot of folks out there that having a frame-mounted safety is an absolute deal-breaker. They either want or don't want. Your less experienced, less competent or confident people really love this guy here because it's frame-mounted safety. I know until I cancel. This one here also has a grip safety. Those two things sell a lot of these, and it's a very good gun by Smith & Wesson. I can't personally tell you whether you should or shouldn't carry a gun with a frame-mounted safety. All I can tell you is this. You should eventually develop the competency to carry the gun completely loaded in condition zero, regardless of the platform that you select. We don't want to go out in public with what is called the dead man's gun. Magazine inserted, but no round in the chamber. That has a completely useless condition for concealed carry. Back to crime statistics. You have less than 3 seconds to access your gun, pull it out, put it on target, and effectively squeeze the trigger. That's it. You don't have the time to be messing around with safeties and what condition is my gun in. Do I have to do this or not? This is the dead man's gun. Train and develop the ability to carry this so you can use it when the time comes. The 9mm handgun is an excellent, excellent choice for concealed carry, provided that the potential buyer understands the weapon system, understands where his skill set fits into that particular gun, and you spend a little bit of time talking about or thinking about what it is you actually need the gun for and what the most likelihood is that you'll have to use it. Thanks for watching our video. Don't be afraid to like and subscribe.